Well, a Great Court man had reason to be worried about his yard. What appeared to be a few sinkholes started showing up, and then, more recently, some deep, long cracks.
We introduced you to him over a week ago. No one could tell him why he had this problem until his father-in-law suggested he call the geologists. It's all new tonight at 6.
You guys want to start on the neighbor's side?
Sure.
Okay.
These folks are part of the South Carolina Department of Natural Resources Geological Survey, full-time geologists. They did some research before they pulled up in Jeremy Welsh's yard in Gray Court.
So I knew that the area is underlain by mostly granite, and so there are no faults in the immediate area.
Jeremy has several holes in his yard and a 40-foot-long crevice that connects them. His neighbor had a similar problem.
It grew and grew and grew to the point to where it was very dangerous for both of us to be able to mow the lawn and everything else.
These aren't technically sinkholes. You need limestone for that, and there isn't any of that here. But there is granite.
We all like to think granite can withstand anything, but it gets weathered too. This looks like sand. That's actually weathered granite.
Weathered by what? Water. Pine forest was removed when houses were built here.
So when you remove that foliage, it creates a destabilization effect where basically the groundwater has more room to flow through the soil.
So when the house was built, was there a slope down?
And water seeks the lowest level. The lawn does dip down toward the fence line, and that's where the cracks and the holes are.
That might be an explanation for why we have the larger cavities that formed on the property.
But just to be sure, the geologists use this. It's ground-penetrating radar. And by moving it in a grid, the geologists get an idea of what's happening under the lawn.
And some of the cracks are pretty obvious.
These images will be analyzed, but...
A lot of times these things can be, they're just simple drainage issues.
More work to do, but...
It makes me feel a lot more confident.
Confident that he'll soon stand on solid ground.
Jeremy's next step will be to get someone like a civil engineer to help figure out a drainage system for that part of the yard. Now, since our first story on this problem aired over a week ago, the DNR says it's heard from at least three others in the upstate with similar problems.